basically why we don't have to worry about our enemies, because God's on the throne, God's judging, he's going to right every wrong, and he's going to make sure that, hey, the people who are oppressed, they're going to be helped out, and the people who are wicked are going to receive for their wickedness. So I'm just going to start off with that real basic, brief overview of Psalm 9. But let's dig in now and just kind of look at, you know, tear us apart a little bit and look at some of these verses. And some of the verses kind of stand alone as well as being obviously in context with the rest of the psalm. And that very first psalm there says, I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will show forth all thy marvelous works. And this is just setting the tone for the psalm of just saying, you know, how much he's going to praise God. We're going to praise God with my whole heart. And this is something that I think we need to remind ourselves of, that when we're praising the Lord, especially praising the Lord in song, as we're just singing, praise him, Jesus our blessed Redeemer, right? We sing songs, we're praising to the Lord, but are you praising God with your whole heart? Is your heart in it? Are you just mouthing words? Are you just doing what the song, you know, well, this is what we do, we come in and we sing some songs, and is that your attitude? Or are you literally praising the Lord with song? Because that's the point. The point isn't to come in and check off a box and say, yeah, I sung three songs, I sung four songs today, and, you know, I did my duty to the Lord. The point when we sing the songs is to praise God and sing forth the praises and exalt his holy name. And we pick songs for a reason, and we pick songs on purpose. It's not just any random song. We like the doctrine in the songs. We like the songs like praise him. They're just going to glorify the name of the Lord. And when we sing, you know, I understand that as people, we are creatures of habit, and you can fall into routines, and it's easy to do that, but we need to continually remind ourselves, hey, we ought to be, what am I doing right now? We're saying, hey, let's praise God. Let's think about the words and feel the words and sing them out from the heart so that you could actually mean what you're singing about. I mean, think about singing in general. What is it that would just make you sing? If it would just prompt you to start singing and praising, you got to be thinking about something that's going to have an impact on you, right? I mean, people don't just, you know, when I'm just working on a computer at work, I don't just all of a sudden break into song, right? It's not like a musical on the job. I'm not that into it and that excited. But, you know, when things happen that make you really excited, that really stir you up, you know, maybe you will start singing, you know, so you get real joyful about something. Well, we ought to be like that with the Lord and have that joy of the Lord in our hearts so that we can praise him with our whole heart. And the only way we're going to be able to do that is by being mindful of the Lord in our lives, that even though we can't physically see a being, see an entity to physically relate to, we know he's there. We know he's there, but we have to keep him in our thoughts by meditating on his word, by, you know, always thinking on things, by prayer, by singing, as part of your daily life, not just something that you do at church, something that ought to be continual. Be praising him with your whole heart. We have so many reasons to praise the Lord. I mean, think about all the reasons. You can't even talk about it without talking about our salvation, right? Because that's the number one most important reason to us that hits home the closest. Salvation from hell, an eternity of hell. Jesus Christ dying on the cross for us. But there's so much more than just that. That is enough. That's enough for you know, eternity, to praise the Lord for his mercy and his long suffering, and by giving us a free gift of salvation and saving our souls from utter destruction. That is in and of itself plenty to praise the Lord for. But thank God there's so much even more than just that. All of the mercies, all of the blessings, all of the great things that God is and does for us. It's not like God has to do anything for us. We're his creation, yet God still does things for us. He still hears us. We know that whatsoever we ask the Lord, he heareth us. Amen.